Link TV, connecting you to the world. Link TV is viewer supported. Watch more at linktv.org.
Link TV presents Mosaic World News from the Middle East. Here are today's top stories.
As world leaders react to Egypt's uprising, demonstrators call for a march of millions. Meanwhile, President Assad claims Syria is immune from Egypt's unrest. Mosaic, world news from the Middle East, begins now.
الاحتجاجات في مصر دخلت يوم السابع إلى ميدان التحرير.
As Egyptian protests enter their seventh day, demonstrators have returned to Tahrir Square in central Cairo and other areas, not far from army tanks heavily deployed on the streets of Cairo and other Egyptian cities. The protesters called for a general strike today and a march of millions tomorrow, vowing to stay on the streets in defiance of a curfew in place from 3 p.m. to 8 a.m. Cairo local time.
توقيت القاهرة وحتى 8 صباحا. وبعد أيام من انسحابها بدأت قوات الشرطة المصرية اليوم بالعودة تدريجيا إلى
Days after withdrawing from city streets, Egyptian police have gradually returned to the capital and other cities to restore security and maintain peace. Police officers were seen directing traffic across Cairo. In addition, security patrols were assigned to help prevent looting and pursue any violators. The army called on all prisoners who escaped from jail to give themselves up and announced they have captured 4,054 of the escaped prisoners and rioters.
54 من السجناء الهاربين ومن مثير الشغب.
In a new development, General Mahmoud Wajdi has been appointed Interior Minister.
المصرية ميدان التحرير الذي بقي صبيحة هذا اليوم بمنأى عن
Last night, thousands of demonstrators held protests in Tahrir Square defying the curfew and demanding change.
الذين تحدوا حظرا لتجوال مواصلين مطالبتهم بالتغيير.
Meanwhile, opposition leader Mohamed El Baradei called on protesters not to turn their back on the revolution and not to stop until all of their demands were met. Our correspondent Ahmed Al-Kilani reports from Cairo.
أحمد الكيلاني.
غير عابئة بقرار حظر التجوال.
In defiance of a night curfew imposed in the country, masses of demonstrators continue to protest in Tahrir Square, though the number of protesters is smaller than we have seen in the past few days. Dr. Mohamed El Baradei, the former chief of the International Atomic Energy Agency, joined the protesters calling for the ouster of the ruling regime. El Baradei and opposition blocs agreed to form a committee that includes El Baradei and other opposition figures to oversee the crisis and help resolve it.
لإدارة الأزمة وحلها وفقا لسيناريو محدد.
We need to form a civilian transitional presidential committee that will help dissolve the parliament, the Shura Council, as well as all districts that have witnessed election fraud. The committee will also amend the constitution in order to hold free and fair elections. The elections will be held under full judicial monitoring, as well as the monitoring of civil society organizations and the international community. Once the constitution is amended and parliamentary elections are held, we will call for fair presidential elections.
Judges and religious leaders from El Azhar have joined the protesters, with each one voicing a specific demand.
I'm calling for freedom, democracy, and integrity. I'm also calling for an end to chaos and security breaches. Security must be restored. Anyone trying to breach security must be held accountable.
The army's heavy presence in the square started to annoy some protesters, who feared the army will be used to disperse them. However, many protesters chanted slogans expressing trust and solidarity with the army. Demonstrators reiterated that the protests will continue until all their demands are met, including reforms, comprehensive change, and the ouster of the ruling regime. They also said the situation will never return to what it used to be.
Nothing will affect us, not even bullets, live ammunition, or bombs. The people are enraged. That's it. This is the end. He has been in power for 30 years. He ruined the country. They send us agriculture hormones to use on our crops. The wheat, which comes from Russia, is for animal consumption, but they are feeding it to us.
Peace.
While the army tries to maintain control of the streets, angry demonstrators are continuing to stage protests, especially in the absence of a political situation acceptable to all sides. Ahmed Al-Kalani, Dubai TV, Cairo.
ويواصل هناك مئات الألاف من المصريين احتجاجاتهم في مدن مصرية عدة، ويواصل الألاف أيضا اعتصامهم في ميدان التحرير في وسط العاصمة.
Hundreds of thousands of Egyptians continue to protest across a number of cities. Thousands of protesters are also continuing their sit-in at Tahrir Square in central Cairo, the Egyptian capital. Demonstrators are calling for a general strike and the start of what they referred to as the March of Millions tomorrow, Tuesday, in Cairo and Alexandria in order to topple Egyptian President Hosni Mubarak. For this reason, Egyptian authorities shut down all trains across the country in an attempt to prevent more protesters from flowing into the capital. The Egyptian president is having his new prime minister conduct an extensive dialogue with all political parties in order to push forward the progress of the so-called democratization and achieve political and legislative reform.
الديمقراطي وتحقيق مزيد من الإصلاح السياسي والتشريعي.
أيام الغضب المصرية غدت سبعة ولا تعرف بعد.
Egypt has entered its seventh day of rage. No one knows yet how it will end. The army intensified its presence around Tahrir Square, the center of the mass demonstrations. Military forces blocked some entrances to the area as helicopters hovered at a low altitude over the crowd. A rumor spread among protesters that new measures are being taken to prevent more people from joining the sit-in and to disperse those still participating. But according to protesters in Tahrir Square, the two sides are still amicable.
I call on the Egyptian people from all sects and all classes to come to Tahrir Square because the army supports the people. The army has never been against the people. The army and the people are together in this.
Measures were implemented on the ground to parallel action taken to contain the situation politically. President Mubarak is having his new prime minister start a dialogue with all factions to push what was called democratization, confirming the need to move toward complete, effective, and urgent political reform. Mubarak also had General Ahmed Shafiq ensure that the government halts inflation, provides job opportunities, and restores trust in the economy. However, these chants indicate that new assignments and unprecedented government changes are not enough to satisfy the demonstrators' demands. They are calling on the president to step down. In a new escalation, protesters are holding a general strike today and a march of millions on Tuesday.
لم يختلف الأمر في الإسكندرية، فقد أطلقت دعوة إلى ما سمي اعتصاما عظيما أمام مسجد.
In Alexandria, the scene was similar. There's a call for a great demonstration in front of Al-Qaid Ibrahim Mosque that will last until the regime changes. Media sources reported that popular committees are refusing to allow the entry of police forces, which spread to many provinces. It seems that finding a solution to this crisis is a perplexing question. In one of their chants, demonstrators asked the army to choose between Egypt and Mubarak. ضباط الجيش وجنوده المنتشرين بين المتظاهرين يظهرون تفهما لمطالبهم. It is clear that the army officers and soldiers who are in and amongst the demonstrators understand the protesters' demands and have vowed not to use force against them. It seems a different position was taken by world leaders. These images show that they are still loyal to President Mubarak, who met with them in the Armed Forces Operations Center. World leaders are the first component if a solution is to be imposed. The second component is the demonstrators' ability to continue and escalate their protests while attracting new segments of the population and overcoming fear sparked by vandalism in the last few days. The most important element is to transform the protest to political mobilization. This is where the question about the power of the opposition arises. As soon as a statement was issued, designating Mohammed al-Baradei to form a delegation to communicate with the army, disputes, even doubts over the man emerged from various opposition groups. The officially acknowledged political parties have also experienced pressure from the government and internal division during the last several years. It seems difficult to find a person from these parties who will gain approval from the army and foreign powers.
تشكلت اليوم في مصر حكومة جديدة برئاسة الدكتور أحمد شفيق.
A new government led by Dr. Ahmed Shafiq was formed today in Egypt. Meanwhile, protests across Egypt have entered their seventh day. Protesters are demanding President Hosni Mubarak step down. Reports say Egyptian protesters are preparing for a march of millions to exert pressure on Mubarak and demand comprehensive reform in the country.
مع دخول التظاهرات وأعمال السلب والنهب والعنف في مصر يومها السابع يبدو نظام الرئيس المصري
As protests enter their seventh day, along with looting and violence, Egyptian President Hosni Mubarak's regime still appears strong. But protesters are also strong and show no sign of backing down. The curfew imposed by the government is no more than meaningless words to them. Protesters say there will be no end to their protests until Mubarak leaves, as fugitives who escaped from prison continue to be captured.
مؤكد أن مصر دخلت مرحلة جديدة ما زال الرئيس المصري فيها وبلا وجل يمارس صلاحيات الرئيس.
It is certain that Egypt has entered a new era, even as the Egyptian president is still fearlessly acting as the head of state. He designated a vice president, fired the old government, and appointed a new one in which he reshuffled the same ministers, with the exception of the new interior minister. He reshuffled the ministers of finance, health, culture, agriculture and irrigation, and commerce.
وما زال يتمتع بدعم قوي من الجيش تجلى في أوضح صوره داخل غرفة عمليات القوات المسلحة.
Mubarak still enjoys solid support from the army, shown clearly in these images from inside the Egyptian Armed Forces conference hall. As police were deployed again in some areas of Egypt, countries around the world are increasingly concerned. The United States, China, Japan, and Saudi Arabia started evacuating hundreds of their citizens in Egypt by plane.
لتجلي المئات من رعاياها من مصر. ومظاهرات المصريين في الداخل والخارج تقابل
Demonstrations in solidarity with Egyptians took place in a number of countries, including Jordan, Turkey, Lebanon, and Venezuela, where protesters attacked the Egyptian embassy. The developments in Egypt continue to draw attention from around the world. Newspapers around the world are talking about the situation in Egypt, proving the massive regional and international attention being given to the events in Egypt.
ما يدل وبقوة على مدى الاهتمام الإقليمي والعالمي بما يحدث في مصر ليبقى العالم كله في
The whole world is waiting to see the outcome of this crisis. The Egyptian economy has been negatively affected by the unrest as the stock market and banks stay closed. Conflicting rumors say the Suez Canal may be shut down, and Egypt's economic assessment index has turned from stable to negative.
من موقع المستقر إلى السلبي. كل هذا والرئيس مع معاونيه أو على الأقل
In addition, the president and some of his supporters are still acting as they have for decades.
وتنضم إلينا من القاهرة عزة محي الدين مراسلة بي بي سي.
Joining us from Cairo is BBC correspondent Azza Mohideen. Azza, what's new in Cairo? Are protesters still on the streets despite the curfew?
من أراد أن يتظاهر اليوم فمن المؤكد أنه بالفعل موجود في ميدان
Those who wanted to protest today are certainly at Tahrir Square in downtown Cairo now, but other neighborhoods are following the curfew.
حظر التجوال بالنسبة للحدث الأبرز اليوم
The big event today was the formation of the new cabinet that included new and old ministers. The most important part of the cabinet reshuffle was the replacement of the interior minister.
تغيير وزير الداخلية المصري الوزير الجديد
The new interior minister is General Mahmoud Wakdi, who has been in a number of positions before, including prison director and security director of Al-Qayyubiya province.
مدير أمن محافظة القليوبية
Some businessmen in the old cabinet, as well as some ministers who have been in their positions for years, were fired.
قال الرئيس السوري بشار الأسد أن بلاده في مأمن من الاضطرابات السياسية التي شهدتها عدد من دول
Syrian President Bashar al-Assad said his country is immune to the political unrest witnessed in a number of countries in the region. He said Syria is a stable country because it does not have strong ties with the United States and is opposed to Israel. In his statement to the American newspaper The Wall Street Journal, Assad added that the protests in Egypt, Tunisia and Yemen were the beginning of a new era in the Middle East. He called on Arab leaders to respond to the people's increasing aspirations, saying he would push reforms this year.
دائما في سوريا إذ قامت مجموعة من السوريين بالاعتصام السلمي أمام السفارة
A group of Syrians organized a peaceful sit-in in front of the Egyptian embassy in Damascus for a second day. They denounced what they referred to as the Egyptian regime's suppression of protesters who are demanding that President Hosni Mubarak leave. Dozens of youth lit candles for the people killed in the Egyptian protests. They also held banners condemning the Egyptian president's regime, calling for security forces to stop killing protesters and for Mubarak to step down. Syrian security elements prevented these groups from reaching the embassy, but no clashes took place between the two sides.
قالت صحيفة هارتس الإسرائيلية أن الكيان الإسرائيلي أوصل رسالة سرية إلى الولايات المتحدة.
Israeli newspaper Haaretz said the Israeli entity sent the US and European countries a secret letter asking them to support the stability of Egyptian President Hosni Mubarak's regime, which is facing a wave of massive demonstrations. It added that occupation officials considered it in the West's interest and that of the entire Middle East to preserve the stability of Egypt's regime, asking the world to curb public criticism of President Mubarak. Israeli Occupation Army Radio, which reported the news, considered the initiative to be criticism of the United States and European countries that don't support Mubarak's regime. For the seventh consecutive day, protesters are demanding regime change, and Arab and international reactions are asking Egyptian President Mohamed Hosni Mubarak to submit to the people's demands.
The wave of anger in Egypt is still being exhibited as we wait for a solution to the current crisis. Amid ongoing demonstrations calling for a change in the Egyptian regime, Secretary General of the Arab League, Amr Moussa, ruled out the possibility of Egyptian President Mohamed Hosni Mubarak stepping down. He expressed hope that a multi-party democracy will emerge in Egypt, indicating that the Arab world is heading towards change. Islamic Jihad leader Khaled al-Bach said his group is monitoring the Egyptian protest movement, indicating that any change will have a significant impact on the Palestinian cause. He said the Israeli entity will lose the most if the Egyptian regime changes. Iranian Parliament Speaker Ali Larijani praised the Egyptian people's revolution and described it as the revolution of the free-hearted. He confirmed that the region is close to witnessing major changes that started with the Tunisian revolution and quickly spread to various countries in the region. Prime Minister of the Israeli occupation, Benjamin Netanyahu, whose entity has a peace treaty with Egypt, confirmed that the latest events in Egypt are being anxiously monitored. At the same time, he called on his entity to show, quote, responsibility and restraint. Internationally, the United States' strong presence was felt on the Egyptian political scene, as Secretary of State Hillary Clinton called for an orderly transition of power that would not lead to a power vacuum. She asked for a well-thought-out plan that will bring about a democratic participatory government. Australian Prime Minister Julia Gillard called on the Egyptian government to show restraint and quickly respond to its people's demand for change. She added that it is the right of the Egyptian people to determine their future. German Foreign Minister Guido Westerwelle expressed his country's solidarity with the Egyptian people. He said life in Egypt could no longer return to normal. British Foreign Secretary William Hague called on the Egyptian president to form a broad-based government and to rush real and tangible reforms. At the same time, he called for the demands of the people to be heard. The UN Secretary General called on the Egyptian government to show restraint and to stop the violence. He confirmed that the government is responsible, first of all, for providing decent jobs and good opportunities for people to maintain a decent living. However, most international condemnation and appeals to the Egyptian government remain hostage to developments on the ground.
Egyptian protesters have again taken to the streets on the seventh consecutive day of anti-government demonstrations. Many say they won't tolerate the Western dominance over the region any longer.
No Israel, no America, no more. That's it.
Press TV's correspondent in Cairo says many slogans in the Tahrir Square are directed against the U.S., Israel, and France. This as the opposition calls on millions of Egyptians to join the rally in Cairo on Tuesday as President Hosni Mubarak hangs on to power. The protesters also call for a general strike on Tuesday.
I've been here for 3 days and I'm prepared to spend the rest of my life here and I'm prepared to die here. Mubarak has been in power for 30 years with despotism, unfairness and injustice. We don't know how to live. The people have had enough. The fire inside us has come out.
I am calling on all the Egyptian people from all the different areas to come and take part in this protest here in Tahrir Square. And that the army is with the people. The army will never be against the people. The army is with the people, hand in hand. We want Hosni Mubarak to leave the country.
The Egyptian protesters say they will continue their protests until Mubarak steps down. At least 150 people have been killed, thousands more injured, during clashes with security forces over the past week. Meanwhile, the Muslim Brotherhood condemned the United Nations and Western countries for failing to take action against the government crackdown on the protesters and the killing of civilians.
I spoke with Middle East expert Yoni Ben Menachem and asked him whether Israeli officials are attempting to convince Western leaders not to abandon Egyptian President Mubarak.
Yes, not only Western countries, but also the United States of America. In a telephone conversation between Prime Minister Netanyahu to President Obama on Saturday, I think Israel is very worried that if the West will abandon President Mubarak, the result will be the what we'll get is the Muslim Brotherhood movement in Egypt through democratic elections, and this will be a disaster for the peace agreement between Israel and Egypt because the leaders of this movement already are declaring that the first step that they will take will be to abolish the peace treaty between Israel and Egypt.
Are we seeing played out before us now a replay of Jimmy Carter's abandonment of the Shah of Iran in 1979?
It looks very similar. Of course, we cannot predict exactly what will happen in the future, and I'm not a prophet, and nobody will gamble on what will be in the future. But what happened in Iran at that time that you mentioned is very similar to the situation in Egypt. This revolution, intifada, coup d'etat, whatever you will call what is happening in Egypt now, will lead to a provisional, temporary, interim government and then to real elections where there is a real danger that the radical Islam movement will be elected legally, and this will put Israel in a very bad situation. We'll have a Shiite, extreme Shiite regime in Iran, and we will have an extreme Sunnite regime in Egypt, and this is very dangerous.
U.S. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton has been talking about seeing a transition to democracy in Egypt. European leaders have been stressing the same thing. How then do you stop the Muslim Brotherhood or the extremists from filling this void that might be created?
Let me try to be polite. I don't think that the Americans really understand what is going on, because Islam and democracy do not go together. And what we might see eventually in Egypt is going from one dictatorship to another dictatorship, going from a secular dictatorship into a religious dictatorship. This is going to be eventually the result, and I'm afraid Americans don't understand that.
Syrian President Bashar al-Assad told the Wall Street Journal today that what we're seeing taking place in Tunisia and Egypt cannot happen in Syria. Is this wishful thinking on his part?
I think it's a wishful thinking. We have to remember what happened many years ago while his father Hafez was the president, and there was a revolt of the Muslim brother in Hamat town in Egypt, and the result of it was a big massacre done by the Syrian army, killing 20,000 Muslim Brotherhood activists in Hamat. Is it possible to exclude this possibility? I don't think it's possible, because what we have in Syria is the Alawite faction, a very small faction in Islam, controlling over a Sunnite majority. So such thing is also possible in Syria, and I think it's only a wishful thinking of Bashar Assad, not more than that.
The views expressed on Mosaic are from contributing broadcasters, not Link TV or its sponsors. The production of Mosaic is made possible by grants from the John D. and Catherine T. MacArthur Foundation, the Firedoll Foundation, and by support of viewers like you. Thank you. Watch Mosaic World News online. Stay up to date with breaking news, read our blog, get transcripts of past shows, and more at linktv.org/mosaic. This program is brought to you by Link TV for educational and non-commercial use only. Link TV is the only U.S. network dedicated to global and national news, uncompromising documentaries, and diverse cultural programs, programs which connect you to the world.